Here is the Stick Shift ZJ pedal kit that comes with the neutral safety switch as well. And just showing you guys my million parts all over engine, old trans, new trans, all that fun stuff, clutch, power steering, blah, 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 blah. Goes on and on.
All right, here we got the clutch and master cylinder in. Little reservoir.
So it bolted right in, really nice with the stick shift ZJ pedal. And this is the factory hydraulics from the 4.0 and I guess the AX5 or whatever the hell that transmission is. But this should fit perfectly. I mean, it's really nice that the plumbing is like in line with everything. It clips into this little retaining clip here. Yes, I know it's a little rusty in here. I pretty much just threw some paint on it after I hit it with a wire brush. But yeah, it fits really nice. Comes down here. It has this protecting on it, I guess for the exhaust and stuff. And I just have it sitting here for now on top of my upper arm. What's up, guys? All right, so here I'm just working on the inside a little bit. So you can see my clutch pedal's in, it's all tightened down. Can't really see that. I just need to wait for the bushing to come, which looks like this. This is the brake bushing. It's the same one, a little broken, but we never use that for the brake. And then I had to cut the pedal down. Could remove it to do it nicely, but I looked up there and it looks not fun to get that out. So could be wrong, but I'm just gonna cut it. I'm gonna put some cardboard and stuff down, just cut it to the same size as the clutch pad because it's supposed to be the same size. And I have those coming too. I have two pads coming, so I'll have an extra one. Then I'll put one on here. What I did here was pull up the console here. I have some wires in here for my heated seats that, well, it actually don't work anymore, but that's beside the point. So I didn't pull it all the way out, it's just kind of hanging here. But there's two Phillips head screws in here. And then you have these four, one, two, three, four, that come out there. And then this is under this, holds that on there. This is held in by 4 8-millimeter screws that go through here. Take those out. 4 13-millimeters here. There's the bolts on, or I'm sorry, nuts on the studs. Take those off. Pop off your shifter cable linkage, and this is the park safety detent, I believe, whatever they call it. So it's connected to your brake pedal. I just cut that with some wire cutters. This I cut from the other side with the angle grinder just to make it easy. Pull it out. And now I am left with this. So probably gonna end up cutting like here, right behind this weld, and then not really sure. I guess I could drill these out, these spot welds. And then I need to figure out where exactly the shifter is gonna come up. Thinking it's gonna come up right like here-ish. It'd be really nice if it was here, like right in the middle, but unlikely from what I've seen before. It's probably gonna be up a little further. So anyway, I'll figure it out and just probably use a hole saw to cut that out then. And then I need to figure out how I'm fastening the inner shift boot to keep basically the cab dust free, heat free, whatever, and keep water out. And then have to figure out what I'm doing exactly on here with the outer shift boot. So have some ideas, but until I get everything in, I'm not really gonna know. So you need to know where that's gonna fall. So that's where I'm at with this. All right, so here's what I got so far. I cut these pieces off. So this is on this side. That was on that side. So this should fit pretty well, I think. I just put this box in here. catch the sparks and stuff, so I caught most of it. I had to vacuum the whole thing out eventually anyway. But I mean, the pedals are gonna be a little closer than I'd like, but it should be fine. And if I really had to or really wanted to, I could take the clutch pedal back out and actually like cut the weld on the pedal bracket or whatever, like this piece. So I could just move it left and make some more room between, just in case foot slips or something. But I think this will be fine. So now I'm gonna try to slip this on. The rubber is pretty pliable, so I should be able to get it on. So let's see. Also, because like the metal behind this, I cut the sides. So here and here, it like mounts nicely into, but the sides don't really have anything to grip onto because there's like a little channel around the whole backside. So the sides are a little flimsy, so I might end up modifying this at some point. Because this is like nice and solid all the way around. But we'll see. As long as it stays on and doesn't get squirrely or anything, it should be fine. But I'm pretty happy with it. Got my new yoke on here from Tom Woods Drive Shafts. Got my Super Duty drive shaft here, all 1350 U-joints. It's I got it on Amazon, it's brand new. I think the U-joints are splicer, but I can't exactly tell. Maybe there's something I can look for, but it has the same body style. Like this, like the squarish body. But anyway, that should fit nicely, I believe, with the shorter transmission. So I see my engine, so I can get that in, get the all the junk put back on that, and then I can get the transmission in, the clutch. I can get my mount made up, which is around here somewhere. Here it is. I got the actual transmission mount from Dodge, but I don't know. I mean, it's probably fine. I don't like, though, how it could possibly separate. Since it's just a rubber in between the two metal pieces. It feels heavy duty, I guess, but even though this is smaller, I kind of like it because it can't fall apart really, because you have your sleeve, which is gonna be attached. I'll probably make a bracket that's gonna attach to this, to the transmission. And then you have your tabs that the bolt goes through. And basically just can't come apart, so it's kind of nice. So yeah, it's tiny, but yeah, we'll see. I could always change it if I have to. I should get the job done for now, at least. That's Ballistic Fab, I think. Oh no, Total Metal Innovations, my bad. So maybe all kind of stuff laying around, but really just gonna get the drivetrain back in, and then I can get all this cleaned up. All my random parts put in. I have to figure out exactly where I'm gonna place my reservoir and route the hoses and stuff like that. So some stuff to figure out, but I just need to get the engine in. So we'll get there soon. What's up, guys? So today I'm kind of putting away at this tranny swap and stuff. So still waiting on the engine to come back from the machinist. He's basically dealing everything internal and slapping it all back together. And then I just have the accessories and sensors and stuff to put back in. Then I'll put that in with the everything else. But today, since there's not much else I can do right now, I'm just figuring out the wiring. So there's the neutral safety switch wiring. So here's the new tranny, the NV4500. Out of a not sure what exactly this is out of, actually, but it should be out of some mid to late 90s Dodge 5.9 liter V8 with the manual trans, but it had to be a 2500 or a 3500 Dodge. They have the heavier duty trans. So
I got this pigtail from Rock Auto for the reverse switch. So that's pretty cool. It's brand new. Okay, so we got our switch here. So reverse switch, the neutral safety switch I have here. Oops. So this comes with the Stick Shift ZJ clutch pedal. And he has a little bracket this goes into on the clutch pedal. And this actually contacts the pedal. So when it's pushed in, you should not be able to start the engine because, let me think about this. So it has to be grounded to start. So I guess when the switch is released, it grounds. So that's when your clutch is down. So I didn't test it yet. I'll get my electrical tester out. But right now it should be in the switch is in the closed position. So then when the clutch is released and the pedal's out, it depresses this, and now this should break the connection, the contact. So it should be open. So anyway, we have this connector, which was the little round guy. I have it here. I might have thrown it. Oh yeah, here it is. This dirty thing. So this was on the old auto trans. That was right here. There's also another connector here, which went to the trans, and I believe this was for the overdrive or some kind of torque converter lockup. So that I'm just gonna leave as is, but we need these three wires. So I don't know which way it went now, but the middle one is for the neutral safety switch. So this just has to be grounded, basically. So I'm gonna run this into the cab and go to one of these little guys here. Then the other one just gonna go right to ground. So basically, like I said, it's gonna be connected. And when the clutch is down, so this switch is out, it should be able to start. Now for reverse lights, that's these two guys. So from the factory, one of them is 12 volts in, and then the other one, when you're shifted into reverse, goes out to the lights. So I was just testing this because I couldn't find a clear answer on which is which. What I'm doing here is taking my ground from the body, and I'm just gonna ground that on the battery as it would be. And then I tested positive to each of these. So here's my positive. I should put this on here. Maybe it'll stay, probably not. Oh yeah, okay, no. Well, anyway, when this is grounded, I found out this is my positive, or this is my out to the lights. So this would have been the positive coming in. Okay, let's change some things around here. So I got my ground in the ground side there. And here we go. Try to see everything here. So if you look back there, got my reverse lights. So that means this wire is the out or to the lights. So this is gonna be my black for the pigtail. It's gonna be my red because this is the in, the hot. 12 volts. This is the out to the light for my pigtail here. So what I can do is get this wired in right now. I don't think I'm gonna have any problems with the position of this wiring, the length, because I think it'll be close enough because the auto trans connector was like here roughly. So it should be able to reach to there fine. Plus I have a little extra length with this, so I'm gonna get my my red 12 volts here. My out to the switch is here. And I'm just gonna solder those in with some heat shrink. And this will be good to go. Then all I have to do is run a wire from the neutral safety into the cab, and I can connect it to the switch. I just don't know exactly how long that's gonna be now, for now, so
I might just leave that since I know what it is now. It'll be pretty easy. Once the transmission is in and I can get the wiring harness back into position, all that fun stuff. Okay, here's just a little confirmation of how the reverse switch works. So I have both of these in here on the connector terminals. And you go over to reverse. You can hear there is continuity. Out of reverse. Nothing. Reverse. Cool. All right, here's what I got. So here's that old solenoid connector that I don't need. Here's the new reverse connector. So I soldered it in, I used some heat shrink or heat wrap, taped it up, and then put the conduit over it. We also wired in the neutral safety switch here. Well, the wire from it. Just left it long. It's like 5 feet or something. So I'll wire that into this then when I get everything put together. So yeah, it's pretty good. I just zip tied this puppy to the harness since it's for the four-wheel drive switch, but I have a different transfer case, doesn't use that style plug, so not important. So this is ready to go pretty much. Try not to stomp on this wire too much before it's in.
As always, thanks for watching, guys.
Here's a little sneak peek, some end resultage here. Everything works great. But part one is done. Now you know. It's really not that hard. The hardest part for me was just learning what to do, really. So for you, it should be pretty easy. You know what the wiring is now, which is very simple. It's three wires. The pedal's easy to install. It's really self-explanatory. There's just two nuts that go in the stud that goes through the firewall. So that was really easy. If you're lucky enough to have an early ZJ, it has that whole little panel that pulls right off. But this, there's that little panel that you can see like the dark around there. It was kind of glued on, so I just pulled it off and there was the three holes for everything to go through. There are little indents up here for these screws. I just threw some self-tappers in it, so that's great. Here should be. So please subscribe, comment, you know, ask me any questions, suggestions. Max would love to hear. And I hope this helps. So stay tuned for part two.